Hello and welcome to DrER.tv. In this video, you're going to learn how to do a stitch just like this one. The link will be in the description below.
Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Dr. Carlo Oller with this laceration repair series of videos using this suture point suture practice kit that you can buy on eBay. And we already done the simple interrupted stitches. We've done the simple continuous stitching. And now we're gonna do the simple interlocking. It's gonna be just like this one, but each stitch is gonna interlock to the next one. As I said before, on the last video, the advantage of the interlocking is one, I like how it looks. And number two, it provides a great deal of hemostasis. It helps the wound stop the bleeding, and it ends up with a stitch that looks just very nice and tidy. And what it does, it pulls the tissue together this way and this way. So it helps really with bleeding wounds, like in the scalp, places where there's tension and things like that. So let's go ahead and get started. Just like before, it's gonna be a regular stitch. So we're going to enter the wound. Sorry. I have this kind of on an angle, so that's not good. Let's do it right perpendicular here. Much better. Grab the edges of the wound, evert it. Make sure you're coming out at the same level on the other side. Make sure you have enough to grab at the other end. And use the forces to help you pull through. And just like before, we're going to do two times forward for a surgeon's knot. Pull and hold. And forward. And that's one, and backwards two, and forward three, and backwards, and the last one should be fine. Nice and tight. All right, this is kind of a short thread, so we don't have to cut that one. Here's where it gets cool. So you're gonna do just like before, you go in the wound and through. This is getting a little tight here, but we're still gonna go through. In. Inversion of the eye. All right, but this time, instead of just going to the next one, you see how it forms a loop right here? So you're going to go through that loop. You're going to grab your needle again, and then you're going to pull. And see what it does here. It's going to pull on that stitch this way, and as I continue to do this alongside the wound, it's going to have like some people call it the baseball stitch. So perpendicular to the wound, I'm just going to go a little bit quicker here. And out. But this time, there's my loop, go through, and pull. And then you got your loop, pull it through the loop before you pull back. Now you could keep going and going and going the whole length of the laceration, but what we're gonna do is we're gonna stop right there and do our last one, because I didn't have a long thread for this laceration repair. I just had this one here. So You can move this like that. You can move it to one side or the other. It doesn't really matter at that point. We're going to do our last one, in and out. With your instrument, you don't want to pinch yourself there. So this one, just like with the continuous, but not the interlocking, you leave that last loop and you're not gonna come through. That's the one you're gonna use to tie and make your last suture or stitch. So you use the, you go twice around and you grab your loop like that, pull it tight. And just like before, you can kind of fasten it so it doesn't unravel, like so. Grab and pull. Grab and pull, forward, grab and pull, backwards, grab and pull. You have about five or six. Now you don't have to do it so many times because it's silk and it holds the stitch very, very well. But if it was proline or ethylene, then I'll probably do like eight of them just to make sure it holds. And this is a continuous interlocking. Again, you know, this is not what it would look like in real tissue. I'm going to show you what it would look like in real. But basically, you're coming through each one, and interlocking with the loop so that it holds its stitch together as you continue to move through the laceration repair. All right, so that's the continuous interlocking stitch. And to be honest, this is probably 80% of my lacerations. Now, when they're complex and they may be deep, then I'll do my dip stitches and bring it closer, and then I'll try to close it with either a continuous or a continuous interlocking stitch. Or if it's a complex wound like this, where you have a V, then I'll figure out, okay, I'm gonna do this corner and tighten that out, and then I'll do a continuous here and a continuous here. Same thing with this. And we'll go through that as we continue to go through our laceration series. And we'll continue to do different kind of stitches here. And then we're going to work on deep sutures and subcuticulars and so on. So stay tuned for this series on laceration repair. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you in our next one. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much for watching, and for other videos, go to www.drer.tv.